ay ikaw din ang paratangan, Rebelde. Anti-Espanyol, anti-Iglesia. Ang importante, gawin mo ang tama.
Don Pedro, di ba nga natatakot?
Bakit ako matatakot magsabi ng totoo?
Ang sabihin mo sa akin, Padre, hindi ba talaga tayo minalas at sinumpang bayan? Buhay pa ba ang alap sa puso mo?
Let's learn more about Gumburza with one of its lead stars, En Chung D, and its director, Pepe Diokno. Direk Pepe and En Chung, thank you so much for joining us here in ANC Head Start. Great for you guys to be here. Good morning.
Good morning, ANC. Good morning, Direk Pepe. Hi, everyone.
Good morning, En Chung. Good morning, Mix. Hi, ANC. Hi, ANC.
Hello, hello, hello. En Chung, tell us more about your role playing Jacinto Zamora.
I think this is a milestone for me. This is something that I've always wanted to do. Every time people would ask me before, I would always say, if they were asked me, what's your dream role? I would always say either historical or biopic. And then I got both in this film. So I'm very happy. I'm very blessed with this film.
Now, En Chung, you've hit this milestone. How did you prepare for it?
Oh, wow. You know what? We're very grateful for the production, for the Jesuits production, because they provided us a historian on the set. They provided us our Jesuits community. They were there every time that we have a shoot. They're there to guide us through with the script. And Direk Pepe is a very collaborative director, which I'm very happy because it's something that would help us with our role. So basically, it's 50% on my part and 50% on the production, which makes it very, very easy for us. Yeah.
Well, that's why the production and the people behind the scenes are there, you know, really in the first place, to be able to help the on-screen actors to be able to perform their jobs, you know, their roles.
Definitely.
Yes, yes. Direk Pepe, is it your first time to make a historical film? What makes this project unique for you?
Yeah, well, it's the first historical film I've done. It's also, I think, the biggest film in scale that I've done. But I think at the end of the day, it's just really a story that we all felt needed to be told. And I'm really grateful that Jesscom has produced this movie and that we got the opportunity to produce this with M-Quest also, of course. It's very timely also because a lot of the themes in the film are themes that are still, I think, present until today. Themes of injustice, themes of, you know, wanting freedom and having a society that's sort of divided. Those are the themes that are in the film.
Mm-hmm. Now, a similar question to En Chung, Direk Pepe, your preparations for this, and at the same time, how does it mean to you? What does it mean to you, rather, in making this film? Because it's ingrained in Philippine history.
Yeah, well, actually, Jesscom has been working on this film for I think about 10 or so years. And I came on board in 2019, so that's 3 years ago. And we were already starting to prepare 2020, and then the lockdown happened. We actually had our first pre-production meeting on March 2020, and a few days later, I think the day after, we already had the lockdown. So we've been, wow. This is a little long time coming. We did a lot of research, as En Chung said. We had a historical consultant. We consulted the writings of Father Schumacher, who is a Jesuit. And then it's been, you know, a lot of preparation in terms of having to mount all these sets and all these scenes. We shot in Taal and we shot in Tayabas and in Itamuros. But I think everything sort of really came together very well, and I'm happy.
And you mentioned, just speaking of, you know, coming together, right? This was destined to come together because you mentioned March 2020, pre-prod meeting, and then obviously COVID happened, the lockdown happened, and then good thing, right? They really pushed for this, Direk Pepe. for this film
to air. Yes, good thing. But originally, it was supposed to be meant for the 400 years of the church, the church in the Philippines, which was in 2020, 2021. Last year was actually the 100th year anniversary of Gumboza's death. So everybody's been really wanting to make this film. But, you know, even though we're a little bit off by a few years, as I said, it's still a very timely film because of the themes, I think.
And we're here. It's going to be just a few weeks away till Filipinos will be able to get to watch your creation. And Chong, you mentioned in an interview that you had to quote-unquote audition for this role. It was yours, you lost it, and then you fought for it. Can you tell us about that story?
I think the perfect term was I prayed for it. It's something that I've, when I first found out about it, I was like, you know what, I would consistently pray for it just to make sure that I will get the role of Padre Jacinto Zamora. And then when we finally started the production and I was like, okay, this is mine. I will make sure that, you know, whatever I have, whatever experience I have for the past 17 years that I've been working, I want to make sure that I'll apply it to this project. So, and in terms of audition, it's really more of asking or Derek, maybe you can help me with this one.
No, your thoughts, Derek?
Not at all. No, not at all. Enchong is someone I've always wanted to work with. And when you put Jacinto Zamora and Enchong's photo side by side, there is very striking similarity. So yeah, Enchong's, I think, always been made for the role. There were a lot of moving parts when we were starting to prepare for this film, and I'm really glad that everything aligned. From, you know, first and foremost, Enchong wanting the role, and second, all the schedules, all of the prep. So, you know, I'm just really happy at the end of the day, everything aligned.
Now, speaking of the physical resemblance from Padre Jacinto to Enchong, the Enchong studying Padre Jacinto's character, is there something similar that you could relate to with his personality and to yours as well? What's it like?
I think something to do with the experience that Padre Jacinto Zamora has to go through. Going through the execution of them. Originally, Padre Jacinto Zamora has nothing to do with the mutiny. And if you notice dun sa trailer, sinabi niya, parang hindi niyo ako pinakikinggan. Simply because, you know, I'm trying to reason out, I'm trying to explain it to the justice system that, you know, this is my truth. And all you have to do is listen. But I think they had to give a figure to the community, to the society during that time that, hey, if you don't shut your mouth, this is what will happen to you. So I think it's something that, you know, that's why we're talking about a very timely conversation, because until now, it's happening. You know, the theme of injustice is still happening. We're still fighting for it as a country. So I've been saying that yes, it might be 151 years ago, but we're still fighting for the same thing in a different form at this very day.
In the modern, I mean, that's just that version. And then when you put it now in 2023, we're still battling the same issues. Battling for the same rights that we are fighting for. Derek Pepe, just that similarity and, you know, maybe some contrast from hundreds of years ago. And of course, you want to put it now in this film. How much, you know, maybe what kind of pressure was it? Was there pressure? What kind of level of pressure did you feel in terms of preparation, the whole production felt in terms of getting the narrative right?
I wouldn't say pressure. I think we were challenged when there was a video that came out, I think during the pandemic, of these contestants on a show not being able to name them. That didn't affect our research, but more than anything, it just made us, you know, just really steadfast in knowing that this is something that we need to do. Maybe going back now to what Enchong said. The line in the trailer that where he says "hindi niyo ako pinakikinggan," that was actually not in the script, but was improvised by Enchong on the day, and I'm really glad that we got to work on that. So he poured his heart into Zamora, and just like, well, there are so many things when we were doing research that surprised us, particularly with Zamora. Like, for example, the fact that Chen Chung said he wasn't really involved in what he was accused of. He was the most human, I think, of the three characters, in a sense that talagang pinagkamalan lang talaga siya. And so when I started doing research, I was surprised. There's so many things I didn't know myself, even though I knew the name Gumburza. There was so much more to the story that I didn't know. So I think for viewers, they will also be surprised by what's in the film. It's really so much more than what we read in textbooks.
Now, what's it like, Direk Pepe, I will stick with you. What's it like working with veteran actors like Dante Rivero, Jaime Fabregas? Of course, Piolo Pascual will play a special role in the film. And how big was that for you guys, Direk Pepe?
Well, for me, it's really been special. I want to talk about Tito Dante for a while because I've also always wanted to work with him. And he's really the kind of actor, very special, sort of breed of actors where, you know, in between takes, even though at his age, he could go back to his tent or could go back to a bed. He doesn't. He stays on set, sits on a monoblock chair or on a on an Apple box and waits for his turn. He's so particular about details. There was one scene that we were shooting and he looks at a spoon that's in front of him and he said, "This spoon is not right for the era." So things like that, the preparation that he went into, it's really just been amazing. Enchong and Piolo had to learn entire scenes in Spanish. Enchong didn't mention that, but that was one of the big challenges. But seeing them, their dedication to the role and really like perfecting it, like perfecting the lines, has just been amazing for me. They did it so well, by the way, that we had a Spanish coach on set. And the Spanish coach during the shoot said that their diction was excellent in Spanish. Watch it again, the finished film, and he said, "Yeah, perfect Spanish." So I'm really just amazed more than anything.
Well, attention to detail, huh? And Chong, for you, what was it like working with veteran actors? And what Direk Pepe mentioned, there's also a Spanish coach, and you had to be able to put that out in the film.
Working with these actors is always a dream come true for me. You know, if I can work with all of the actors in the Philippines and outside the Philippines, different directors also, because every time I get to do that, I'm learning something new. So I'm very fortunate in that aspect. As for the Spanish one, like I'd make sure that the night before I will call on the Spanish coach after he showered for the day of the shoot. After he showered, I will message him like, "Coach, can we have a throw line session in my room?" And then he would gladly do it, and we would go through it like 100 times if possible, just so when I arrive on the set the following day, it's very natural, because it's my assignment as an actor to portray that in such a way that, you know, it's very natural and with the emotions at the same time. So I enjoy the process. I honestly do. That's why I'm so excited to show this film to our audience.
Yeah, the attention to detail, as I mentioned a while ago, is really phenomenal. And Chong, just would like to go stay with you. And you're mentioning your story about how you would call... I mean, I also read this in an online interview, how you would always collaborate with Direk, with your coaches. Has this always been part of your process? Or how has this process, you know, contributed to your growth as an actor?
I think I always credit the people that guided me through while I was growing up. I think everyone knows that I started as a swimmer when I was younger. At an early age of 6, I was already being guided by my coach. And I find the goodness out of it. You know, something good always come out if you just listen to, you know, people from my parents, from my teachers, from elementary to high school. So I always say that I'm such a good follower in that aspect. And now that I get to apply that again with my work, getting to collaborate with Direk Pepe, getting to collaborate with different directors, I see the beauty of it. I see the benefit of it. And I'm very glad that, you know, there are filmmakers risking everything so that we can put out a quality film like this.
Mm-hmm. And Chong, it takes you back to your athlete years, huh? When
yes, definitely. Say,
makinig ka lang sa coach mo. Just listen to your coach.
Yeah, yeah. Diba? Or kahit yung mga matatanda, makinig ka kasi sa magulang mo.
That's true. That's yeah. true. So all those values, you take it, you were able to apply it in this project. Direk Pepe, what kind of importance does this film, you know, putting history back in its rightful place, you know, in the knowledge of fellow Pinoys? You mentioned about, you briefly touched on this a while ago, but you guys, you know, being in the entertainment industry, in the film industry, you know, having that responsibility in terms of this topic.
I will maybe first say that we did still approach this as a film, and it's an important story. We really wanted to get to dig more than what's in the textbooks and not present like a sort of textbook understanding of what happened. It's really, there's still a large part of it is a creative interpretation of what this means for us and for me as a filmmaker. So the story, the core story of three priests, I think, who were wrongly accused is something that's just really moving. And focusing on that, I think, really grounded our storytelling. So when we were actually like, doing the film and writing, that was first and foremost, like, how do we tell a good emotional story? And of course, there's still that basis of historical fact, but we do have some creative license in the film. To me, at the end of the day, I think what's important is the takeaway of people. And if they're able to take away this just really, I think, a moving story of three priests. And I think that my job has been done. But yeah, it's a big responsibility, I think. There's not a lot of historical films being made in general, but also after the pandemic, it's been really risky to mount such a big production. But we were just really, but first and foremost, me very grateful that VHSCOM and MQuest producing this because we got the opportunity to do it. So yeah.
And Chong, maybe any thoughts you want to add to that? You know, being a medium. Of course, as we revisit history in this form.
Definitely. I remember when I was in high school, we got to watch Jose Rizal. And that film made me understand and dig deep on the struggles and the challenges in our history. And film showing is always a good tool for us to get educated. So now that I'm in the position wherein I can shine a light on our certain personalities in our history, specifically Padre Jacinto Zamora and of course the Gumburza, it's an honor. And at the same time, I'm very glad because this will educate but at the same time entertain our students.
And it definitely will be an experience just like it was an experience for you and Chong. That film back in high school. Lastly, Chong, kindly invite our viewers to catch Gumburza in the MMF.
Yes. Everyone na nakakasama natin today, I'd like to invite you December 25, Christmas Day, we will be showing Gumburza, the film Gumburza, hatid sa inyo ng JESCOM community, JESSuite community, and of course, directed by Pepe Chokno. Magkita-kita po tayo. Pasok po tayo sa Metro Manila Film Fest and this will be an exciting year for everyone. Thank you.
Definitely a film to watch, Gumburza. Thank you very much, Enchong D and Direk Pepe Jokno. Thank you so much for joining us here on Head Start. Have a great weekend.